banger. It's one of those words that's buzzing in the zeitgeist as of late, like binge or whole ass. Unfortunately, if you're hangry, binging a whole ass won't satiate your hunger, only expunge your spitty horniness. However, a new word is creeping its slender, sticky hands into the minds of millions. Rage filled. That's right, you've eaten Thanksgiving dinner jam-packed with the tricky fan, and you're ready to scream about Trump to your left-leaning queer cousin while showing off nay, gifting your family with the presence of an incomplete order summary for a gun you're wanting to purchase. The more you eat, the angrier you get, and the more scared your family is. And to our listeners, if your uncle is a crotch-faced alien in a 1930s scuba suit tailored to his own potato-shaped body, keep him away from the freaking desserts. My name is James.
I'm Nicole.
And this is Mostly Speaking Sentai. Guys, like I said, my name is James, and we learned two safety tips today. One, don't play right behind a parked car. Unless you're playing freaking paintball, then you gotta be behind them. You're out with your boys just having a great time, and you know when a paintball smacks into your mask and shatters and gets into your mouth? The only better feelings are cracking a cold brew dog and washing it down your throat.
Brew Dizzog?
Brew Dizzogs indeed, or having a hot lady spit in your hole.
Wow, okay.
Oh, yeah.
Jesus Christ.
Oh, thank you, Jesus, for giving us hot spit
from a hotter
lady.
I thought you were just
going
to read the tip.
No.
I didn't know you were going to make up a whole goddamn story.
No. And guys, guess what? The other tip we learned? Even if it's far away, use the pedestrian bridge for safety. Because if you're just flinging yourself into the ongoing traffic, they might see you if you're doing such from the side of the road. You have to go up to a pedestrian bridge.
Don't tell me what to do.
And drop yourself down. Climb over that fence. And you better have bolt cutters if it's one of those domed fences. Yeah, guys. Hashtag ways to kill yourself. Let
Hashtag
us know.
Domed fence?
Yeah, pedestrian bridges will have a domed fence to prevent people from jumping over the edge.
Got it.
So then you're kind of like Spider-Man wrestling. You know when Spider-Man wrestles? He's crawling on top of the cage and people are like, whoa, this dude must be a spider.
Sure.
Guys, let us know. Tobey Maguire or Tom Holland. Hashtag Fight of the Spideys.
Aren't there like three Spider-Mans?
So there's also Donald Glover. There's gotta be Guy from the 70s.
No,
Japanese
like there
one.
Was, isn't, there's
Andrew
Tobey Maguire,
Garfield.
The person now, but there was someone in between those
two.
No.
Tobey Maguire was the ones from the only Spider-Man in my
All right,
book.
Never mind.
And
just move on.
Sir Andrew Garfield, he was knighted. Our guest knows that. And Tom Holland, who's just a little scamp, he's like, Iron Dad's my man. And
you mean Iron Man's your dad?
And Captain America, he's my uncle.
Yeah, I guess.
That's how things roll. And I saw he tweeted that once. He said, with my cousin Thor picking up dad and Unky. And then it's those two holding hands, I think. Guys, let us know if you've seen that tweet. Hashtag, who gives a fuck?
Uncle Cap.
I don't know where I was going with that.
Wow, okay.
Guys, we got to get to our guest because we know two things about him. He's beefy as hell and hilarious because of the comedy collective he's in. You know it. You love it when Melzer's on, so you better show him the same goddamn respect. To our guest, have you listened to an episode of this?
No.
Okay. I forgot to tell you, please listen. Please
Welcome.
Listen. Like that King Gordy song, you know, No Lights, where he's talking about selling
no,
his
no
own mother
knows.
Crack rock. It's a real story and a real song. But guys, from Muscular Clown and the upcoming web series, Todd Groban's Going Away Party, we have Sir Matthew, because he's been knighted as well.
This is a surprise to me as much as it is to anybody else who knows me, but I will take the knighthood with, you know, full pleasure.
And James, you can't knight people.
I think he can.
Yeah.
And I will accept
that. He can and he will.
Exactly. I'm a duke, a lord, lady, and queen of England.
My understanding is if you print it or you record it, then it is true.
Yes.
Right. So now.
It's being recorded right now.
I am
a knight. You say it enough times.
Do you think. Never mind. I was going to. Okay. So do you think the queen could go to someone who's like in a coma and knight them? Or do you need consent to be knighted?
No, she's the queen.
Okay. So you can force knighthood on someone. That's odd.
Almost certainly.
Okay. Wait, almost certainly she can or almost certainly it's odd?
Both. No, I don't think it's odd. I think it's almost certain that she can do that.
Nicole, we got to get in on this knighthood stuff.
Because she's like recruiting you.
But...
You know what I mean?
Okay, so if let's say Cutco Knives wanted to recruit you to be on their team like they did to me, can you be like me and refuse it, or do you have to do it?
You have to do it.
Oh,
how
shoot.
Low are your bank accounts?
Oh, at the time I was desperate for a job.
Then you had no choice.
Okay. But then I think I got Burger King and I was fine.
Were you, though?
Oh, picture me. I barely like following up with people about podcast recording, which I was very nervous to ask you to be on this show.
You should be.
He's a knight.
Oh, yeah. I made him such. I made you. But think of me going door to door trying to sell knives to people.
You're just being like, I have these knives, and you just like drop them all.
Have you thought that maybe the reason you had such a hard time was because you set your aim too high? I mean, you said you went to Burger King, and I have a feeling they already have all their own knives, and you didn't need to sell to them.
But I knew that if I could sell to them.
I mean, they definitely need sharper knives.
Yes, I got them hooked. And that's,
do they? It all comes pre-prepared and frozen, right?
Not
See, I'm
things
thinking
like,
specifically the tomato cutter, which would just fucking mash it into a pulp instead of actually slice it.
So the Burger King we worked at
it was fucking
loved
terrible.
To cut corners. And what was
I'm sure that was just a bad one from the dozen.
Oh. Well, I was going to just call out
Don't even fucking get me started with all the bullshit I put up with there.
They would wait so long to get new blades for the tomato cutter that it would literally just mush it. It was terrible. And also with the onion cutter, to the point where, like, when you have a fresh blade, it's great because it doesn't spray the juices right into your eyes and make you cry for the rest of the day. When it got bad, which was mostly what it would just cut and just fling it right into your eyes. And unfortunately, you had to take you tilt your head away from the blades and let it cut. But that's hazardous because it could cut you. And then bloody, bloody onions.
Or, you know, they would, like, not teach you how to do something. And then they're like, how do you not know how to do that? It's like, because you never fucking taught me. Or they would, like, tell you to do something a certain way. And they're like, don't do it that way. And you're like, okay, but you told me to do it this way. And they're like, no, I never told you to do it that way. And then you're like, what the fuck? And then you just stop talking because you're mad. And you know you're not going to win the argument.
So, question.
Or that time on Christmas Eve when you ran out of dish soap. So the manager told you to wash the dishes with the soap that you use to clean the floor.
Yeah.
So you all still eat at Burger King, correct?
No.
Oh, what? We get Burger King brekkie?
Like once a year.
It's so good, guys.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But also, that's a Michigan franchise who operates this way. I wish I could remember the franchise's name to call them out. They also franchised all the Chili's in Michigan area.
Or that time the microphone wasn't working and then the regional manager's like, you're just talking too quiet. So then I'm literally yelling into the microphone and everyone else is laughing because they know that he's just an asshole. But it's like, I have to. Or that one time when the drive-through mic was just like this fucking awful high-pitched noise in your ear and they were like, just shut it off in between talking because you would like shut off your mouthpiece. and the noise would stop and you could still hear them ordering and you would just have to do it that way, and it was fucking bullshit.
There really is a lot of Burger King trauma in this podcast.
Oh yeah.
I said don't get me started and you got me started, so.
Okay, also I would like to say this. I worked there for 6 years. Nicole worked there for like six
One
months.
Year.
Right.
Yeah, it wasn't, did you ever Maybe. Work in fast food?
I did not work in fast food.
But call centers, for sure.
For sure.
Yeah, call centers are a different beast that we don't need to get into.
You know how, like, everyone mops the floor side to side? Because that's how you fucking
yep,
mop a floor.
I already
floor.
Know where you're going with this.
And then the regional manager's like, what the fuck are you doing? That's not how you mop a floor.
That
just dumps water all over the floor, which is just not how you fucking do anything. And then goes, like, forward to back
to
and
like,
is, like
scrub
mopping
it.
That way, and I'm like, that's not how you fucking mop.
That is how you mop
it's
at the
not.
End of the day, and then you mop it again. So like that's to like get everything up, and then you go over it again side to side. That dude was so dumb.
Yeah, he's a fucking asshole.
Oh god. Mm-hmm. The dude before that was much better because he kind of was a, I've worked here for so long, I really don't care as long as it gets done. And then this other guy was fresh to our branch,
yeah.
And then he was trying to toss things mm-hmm. up. And he wanted me to stay there. And I said, I got a new job. It pays much better. There's no way you're going to keep me. And he was like, we'll match it. And I was like, dude, I am an assistant manager and you are paying me $7.25. You're not going to bump me up past $10. If I've been working here 6 years and still make
so $7.25.
You're
saying the six years that you were living the dream did not end on the happiest of notes. You had a confrontation.
Or that one time I came in.
We gotta stop this. We have to let him talk.
My shift started at 11, but they didn't tell me, like they didn't need me. And didn't tell me until I got there. So I literally just had to wait an hour to clock in. Like they made me just sit mm-hmm. in the fucking, like where the tables are. And guess whose decision that was? The fucking regional manager.
Fuck that dude. Yeah. I'm glad I got out there when I did. I'm sorry. No, so she holds resentment to me because she just got the job. And then
I don't hold
because
resentment
of the poor
to you.
Quality standards.
I just fucking
the rusty
hate
knives.
That place.
The ill-cut tomatoes.
Yes.
Yes.
It was just like, think of just like a mashed tomato. That's what we were putting on sandwiches.
You mean tomato sauce?
Yes, pretty much.
And
we were
like,
making our own
ketchup.
Yeah.
To go wash the windows. You'd go wash the windows and you would hear like the drive-thru going off. Knowing that it was like busy, but you look over and the two managers are literally just standing there doing nothing. But then you get yelled at for not helping out with drive through.
Well, because they're just sitting, because they're standing there because no one's come up to that second window yet. That's the only thing they need to do.
Apparently, mm-hmm. even though they both have headsets on. And they're like, oh, well, you need to multitask. I'm like, I literally can't fucking wash windows and do this when it's a rush at the same time. That's impossible.
Would you say
and
that there was a caste system at this particular Burger King?
I would
location?
Say the whole thing is bullshit. And I was on level with Linda. She was the only person I had respect for.
Linda was someone just working towards social
she
security.
She was like 60 or 70 and was like this. She was like totally just like, this place is fucking a trash hole and I can't wait until I can fucking leave. And I was like, yup.
It's a setup.
But everyone
well, you
else
did
was
say
like,
they owned the Chili's. So
yeah, oh yeah.
There's kind of a conspiracy there.
Yeah, they
okay, so I'm done.
Yes. Okay.
That wasn't even all of it. Not even close.
Oh my, how? You worked there such a little time. There
was
once
fucking awful.
Please don't let my presence stop the catharsis from the Burger King.
And they were like,
escapades,
hey, are you gonna
you
miss
know?
Anyone when you leave? And I was like,
right.
Fuck no.
I know the listeners can't see it, but I'm assuming that's where all these branded spatula marks you all both have on your arms came from. From
yes,
the Burger
absolutely.
King experience.
Ooh, remember when the game changer happened? They were trying to rebrand Burger King and to do it, we didn't get a remodel.
Burger Dukes?
We wish.
Burger Baron? Actually, Burger Baron's a great fucking name.
I think there is a, unless it's, is that a That 70s Show? Isn't there a Burger Baron in that?
I don't know.
Is it really?
I think, I know there's a show with Burger
Baron.
Well,
as we stated earlier, if it's recorded, it's truth. So it is not a thing.
Okay.
I am a knight and I will obviously make the Burger Baron chain.
Yeah, guys, he can do whatever the fudge he wants. So don't add us on Twitter. I would like to say one Burger King story. I did not call off
at all. Oh, because we were done, right? And,
well, you were committed. You were there for 6 years.
Yes, I
you
was.
You would never call off. We know this.
I was nursing that resume.
How about when literally no one would show up would never do it? Like, none of the management would do anything about it and be like, why is no one showing up for work? And I'm like, because nothing's going to happen to them.
Yeah, because
Why would they?
They never fired anyone because they were family.
Always short-staffed.
Family?
Yeah, they were either family, so some nepotism, or they wanted to have sex with them.
Wow.
Yeah. Good thing it was never both.
So when you left the Burger King, you left your family. Wow.
Oh, I did not have... Besides Nicole, I never worked with family there. My brother tried to get a job there, but I think I snaked him and got the job before him, so I wouldn't be grounded during the summer.
So I'm like super biased whenever I see stuff about like fast food workers are fighting for a right to get paid more money. And I'm like, no, they fucking all suck.
Whoa. I was good.
Mm-hmm. No.
I deserved 15 an hour.
Hot takes.
Oh, man. Or even
you
hotter
could just get
burgers.
A better job.
Okay, can I tell my last Burger King story? Where are we at? How?
I mean,
because like
it sounds like there's a lot
of people
oh my
yeah.
Nicole, I'm going to cut you. I just need
just cut this, my mic.
Yes. Okay, so
you know, I'm just gonna say because I know you want to talk, so I'm gonna deny you that opportunity.
Okay,
but I definitely feel like there's some Burger King resentment and trauma from one corner of this studio, and from the other corner. There is some, it's guised as, you know,
okay.
criticism, but really there's some deep-seated loyalty here.
Or
right?
How we like,
yeah,
we're always short on something,
oh
yet did inventory every fucking Sunday.
Yeah.
I'm like, how are we out of shit? That
because,
doesn't make any goddamn sense.
Because if we review this conversation, first off, it was like, do you all still eat there? And it was like, never. Oh, yeah, totally. And it was like, and then you sat there and you tried to defend the one time you took some PTO for yourself.
No.
Because you were like, because I wouldn't call off. And it was like, goddamn, man, it's just a fast food chain. You could call off. You probably should.
I went
or
there.
Or should have.
I was making food. This was maybe 7 o'clock in the morning.
That is generally the
and
MO,
then,
Burger King.
Yes.
Okay, at Burger King.
And then I threw up in the mop station. And then I was
Classy.
Like, hey,
ew.
I had to just like wash up and keep making the food. And
but
then,
after you vomited into the bucket, the regional manager proceeded to dump it all over the floor, and then you had to mop it. I now see where this is going. We're now coming
That's
full
why
circle.
I had to spray so much this water, but I was against it.
You're just pushing around the throw up. And then
that's not how you clean a floor? Because you were really adamant earlier that spraying the vomit around was not...
Vomit's it's a good natural cleaning thing for grease because it has that stomach acid in it to break down the grease.
Acidity.
Yeah.
Naturally.
Yeah. Like when you poop.
I'm going to barf.
When you.
Although, doesn't the grease settle it? That's why you eat greasy Burger King when you're really hungover and stuff. It's kind of like
no
a
idea.
Give and take. It makes the Burger King bearable at the same time when you're really hungover and in pain.
When you eat greasy food and then you poop, is your poop greasy? No, because the stomach acid's getting it out.
I don't know. I mean, I personally don't touch or examine the quality of my poop. I can't actually say if it is greasy or not after I've had a hungover meal. Now, maybe it's different for you because you being a sober loyalist to the chain, maybe, you know.
He knows I'm sober. I mean, I'm straight edge. I'm not sober. It's saying
You're not sober?
Oh, I'm high as hell on life. But guys, let me know. Like, because if it was a greasy... Let me know if it's a greasy poop.
Oh no! Don't tell us about your
butthole. Would feel it,
James.
And then you wipe it, and then you're like, "Ooh, it feels greasy on my hole."
This sounds like a Facebook poll that you should probably put up there,
or a Twitter poll.
No,
mostly speaking, Sentai is much more active on.
What were you saying about puking?
Oh, so I puked, and then the only times I ever had to go home was because I was clearly visibly sick and they were like, James, you can't be here right now. But I'd still go in.
Because you were that fucking loyal to Burger King, you wouldn't go home. I hated calling off.
Because I hate calling off because I know what that does to the staff. Because I fucking hated when people called off. Also because I knew people why they were calling off. Because they just got sloshed. And then there was this one specific person, Johanna Peterson. I will call them out by name. Who...
Slander.
Would open.
Libel.
And it would be 2 hours after we're open. And I would still be the only person there because she wouldn't show up.
That's super shitty.
Yeah.
Why were they allowed to open?
I don't know. It's so fucking stupid.
Oh, right, because they worked at Burger King, that's why.
Oh, yeah. Also, because I believe they were family with the manager.
Yeah.
Ah, the nepotism.
Yeah, the nepotism.
That you mentioned earlier. Yes. Yeah.
And because the assistant manager wanted to bone them, so it was a combo. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sure.
But
they
general
were family,
assistant.
Right? So it was actually incest at the Burger King?
No, remember it. Or wait, no, I forgot
well,
to say this.
Well, is it nepotism or is it incest? Can we get this straight? Because okay. I'm very confused now.
I forgot
both.
To tell you that this is a comedy series, Car Ranger. Yes, we are a Sentai podcast, but
is
remember
that what we're
mostly.
Doing?
But we say yes and to everything during this season. So, yes, there was just a fuck ton of incest at this Burger King. Just pounding it out and getting flipper
with poor
babies.
Quality knives.
Yeah. And that's how we fucking got on here, guys.
Right.
Cutco, baby.
Wait, so like.
It can
not,
cut leather.
Okay, but you're not mad about how you used to have to scrub the outside.
Oh, okay.
So you're actually really sold on the Cutco product. Not only are you sold on Burger King, you're also sold on Cutco.
They made him scrub the pavement, like
okay,
wash
so
it with
James,
soap
I'm gonna
and
need
water.
You to put a pin in it real quick. Nicole, what happened to James that made him so susceptible to these corporations, to these conglomerates? Actually, does Cutco even qualify as a conglomerate?
You know, after Burger King, he worked for Dr. Pepper. So, you know, you're really
how do you feel about Dr.
Something.
Pepper, James?
It's okay. I'm kidding, guys. Dr. Pepper's. I will say soda in general gives me a
sure.
headache, but if I'm going to have a soda now, Dr. Pepper, actually, I am a
and
fago.
And hell be damned if I drink so much Dr. Pepper that I vomit into the...
The mop bucket.
The mop bucket.
Or was it because you were drinking Cutco knives? Was it that kind of day?
Actually, back then I was very suicidal, so it could have been.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because you were working at the Burger King
yes,
for 6 years.
Yes, yes. God, it was a constant roller coaster of I'd get in and I'd be like, you want to know what? I'm going to turn my life around. This is going to be fucking great. Then
not
a rush would happen.
That fucking job.
A rush would happen. And then I'm like, God, I fucking hate my life. I should just go home and fucking suck on the exhaust, Car Ranger. And it was a constant roller coaster throughout the day.
Sure.
Until I met Nicole and the skies turned bright.
As I've said many times, my personal hell would be working at that Burger King with Love Shack on repeat.
Love Shack!
Over the intercom.
Baby, love
now,
Shack.
I do have to confess that I do have a hankering for some Burger King after all this. I mean,
it
I just
worked.
Can't, you know, the nepotism and the debauchery and the vomit. Just really, you know, yeah. Sets the stage
I mean,
for
like, the worst thing, people always ask, like, oh, did you do anything to the customers? Food. It's like the worst thing I ever did was just not salt fries. Like, oh, fuck this person. Don't salt those fries. Make them live longer with themselves.
But hey, guys, are you hunkering for some Burger
hunkering?
King right now? Yeah, hunky burgers. And you're just like, oh, man, I really want a big kid's meal, but I don't have that kind of change. I only have 90% of what a big kid's meal is. Use promo code Mostly Speaking Sentai for 10% off. You can buy
only
that.
Only through the drive-thru.
Only drive-thru.
And of course, this is true because it is recorded.
Yes. Sir Matthew of Knighthood. Guys, should we get...
I can't. You should... He's just the official third co-host to this podcast.
Hey, I'm fine with that. So guys, let's finally
this
get into
great.
Sentai. Matthew... What is your experience Ooh. Or exposure?
Did you even do the episode summary
No,
yet?
I asked this
oh,
first,
Jesus
and
Christ.
Then, yeah.
My exposure in general, or to this So not hot takes on the episode yet. Just
no.
My general experience.
With
I mean,
Sentai or Power Rangers.
Like, have you
sure.
watched
so,
it?
So Power Rangers for sure. You know.
No, we don't know. That's why we're asking.
When I was 8, I think that was the pinnacle of my Power Rangers life because mom made me a Lord Zedd costume that she spent like 40 hours on.
Do you have a picture of this?
I definitely don't, unfortunately.
Oh,
it's like in a photo album back at home, which hasn't been digitized because, you know, my parents are baby boomers.
Can your mom take a picture on a phone of the picture? So we can post it.
She honestly probably wouldn't even remember. She made a lot of costumes for us because she was like that and wonderful.
Crafty
so nice.
As hell.
But yeah, it was.
My mom just threw dishes at me.
One time.
So she took a red sweater and red sweatpants and then used aluminum foil to do the rib cage and the pauldrons and all of that. And then I had a mask with a like. You know, the visor and all that. And so,
God.
Yeah.
That's so dope.
It really was. But to be fair, once the villains changed from Zedd and Rita, I did not stick along.
So, it's Car Ranger is where you probably. Oh, no. Zeo. Yeah. Zeo was when they used O Ranger stuff. And you were like, no, thank you, sir.
Yeah.
I have the hiccups.
But outside of that, I know the, what was it, Beetleborgs? Was that what they were called in the States? And then also, wasn't there another bug-themed guy who rode a motorcycle?
Kamen Rider.
Kamen Rider.
Okay. What did they call him in the States, though?
The Masked Rider, which is just a direct translation of Kamen Rider.
Okay. Yeah. So I was vaguely familiar, but I couldn't get behind those because they didn't have dinosaur robots.
Yeah.
Oh, and then I definitely saw the Power Rangers movie with Ivan Ooze.
Yeah.
Also known as Apocalypse from the Apocalypse X-Men movies. So.
Wait, that's the same actor?
No, but they do look very much alike. When I first saw those photos of Apocalypse, I was like, mediocre, and then compared it to Ivan Ooze because it looks a whole lot like him.
Man, Ivan Ooze is my favorite color of purple flesh color.
You should really stop eating that Burger King. And that's not flesh if it's purple.
Uh-oh. It's the best kind of flesh. Human flesh, guys.
I haven't seen any, like, new Marvel movies except for Deadpool. I say I should be fired, like, every time a new one comes out.
She works
don't
at a comic
it.
Book store.
Oh. Well, don't let them listen to this.
But then Rachel made the point of, like, hey, if they wanted us to, they would give us free tickets.
Yeah.
And they don't, so...
Huh.
Or screeners.
So they're liars.
So.
Don't wiggle your eyebrows. Thick. You don't have them. Quit it. It's so cute, though.
I have
though.
Muscles.
Ooh, yeah, you do. You're stacked
just
as hell.
Because you don't know how to do the wave like Jack Black.
Do the wave?
Yeah, with your eyebrows.
You don't know how to do the wave?
With my eyebrows, can you?
No.
Okay. I don't either.
Mm.
It takes practice.
Okay. Guys, let's get into the episode summary and then into notes.
See, you're jealous.
Jealous of what? You? Yeah, I wish
God
I looked exactly like you. Just think, if you and I kissed in the same
God
body.
Fucking damn it, James.
Nice,
way
guys.
To make it weird.
Yeah, I do every single friggin' episode. You expect something different when it's always the same. That's called
it's
being
true.
Insane in
you
the
said
membrane.
It, not me. It's recorded, so it's true.
Have you ever heard
it
the Spanish
true.
Version of
yeah.
Insane in the Membrane?
Nope.
It's just like insane. It's something, and then they go, muy caliente. It's still Cypress mm-hmm. Hill. It's just that.
Uh-huh.
My cousin gave me a mix CD, and it had that on it. Muy caliente.
Your cousin sounds dope as hell, bro.
He is. He lied to me constantly, though, saying, yeah, we opened for Obi Trice. And I was like, oh, my God, you guys did. That's so cool. They
sounds
never
like my
did.
Fucking dad,
yeah.
bro.
Whoa, your dad opened for Obi Trice?
Yeah.
Real name,
ask
no
him.
Gimmicks?
Ask him. He'll say he did.
He'll be like, yeah, I rode my dirt bike there, too. then I gave Nicole the dirt
no,
bike,
he'd
of
probably
course.
Say no and then say something racist because he's a terrible person.
Yeah. Obi Trice is of a different race of that of your dad.
Yeah.
Car Ranger. So, guys, let's get into this episode summary. Ooh, there's silence in there, but that got cut out. Today.
Well, why'd you say
what?
It?
Because it's funny, guys.
Are you going to cut that out, too?
No, this all stays
that
in.
That doesn't make sense.
Only silence and get cut out, baby.
Are you cutting that out?
No, because
I'm so confused.
Ooh, also racial slurs. Nicole, I should cut that out.
No, I didn't say anything.
Ooh, you peeking. That's the only slur in my book. I'm kidding, guys.
Is
I'm
this
very
considered
woke.
The gold of the episode?
Yeah.
Is this the pinnacle? Okay.
For some reason, we have a strong fan base. Not a large one, a strong one.
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's not very big, but our fans fucking love us.
Yeah,
we
don't know
them.
Why. So we jokingly argue a lot on this podcast, and one of our fans reached out to us and said, hey,
Duo Grun Fox, we love you.
Duo Fox of Grun, we love you. And he asked, hey, I'm catching up on episodes, and I just want to ask, are you and Nicole's relationship good? And mm-hmm. I said, yeah, what are you talking about? And he said, just that last one, you guys were arguing a lot. And I said, we do that for comedy purposes.
And because you fail to acknowledge her trauma from the Burger King that you so love.
But maybe I just have a Stockholm syndrome.
Yeah, you definitely do.
Yeah, this, guys.
That's the only way you could work there for 6 fucking years.
Also because my dad raised me to have pride in my work.
I developed.
And to never call
like,
off.
Yep.
Ever.
Like, TMJ.
That's lockjaw, I think.
When you like fuck up your jaw in your sleep.
Yeah, you also cried a lot back then, and I freaking thought it was so cute.
That was a different situation.
Yeah, but I mean, you probably still cried because you had to go to Burger King.
I mean, definitely didn't help.
Uh-oh, guys, go work at Burger King. It'll help you put hair on the chest.
Don't fucking work there.
Guys, I love corporations.
I said I would never work at a fast food place, and then I did, and I was right. I shouldn't have done it.
Let me get to the episode summary. All right. Remember, please, Matthew, for the love of God, interrupt this, because then it's just a crazy person screaming into a mic while two people listen.
He wants you to say shit.
All right, today in the hot, stank summer room, we watched episodes 4 and 5 of Car Ranger entitled A Red Light to Enlarging and Up Ahead, Geki So Fusion, respectively. On the topic of respect, I want all you fans to disrespect me on Twitter because that's what I deserve because I'm a sexy, dirty garbage. Ooh, just like our good friend Crotch. Oh, I love that burp. Crotch, he's trash with a plump-ass belly button ready for the picking. I used to pick my belly button until it turned into a beer keg. What was on tap, you ask? A 7-year-old's blood. Because I picked it so much that it just drained out blood. Yeah, guys, save me from the self-harm I would inflict on myself as a child by disrespecting me in an iTunes review. But still, 5 stars, please, please. I'll read it on here. Just tell me I'm trash in the friggin' review.
Jesus.
If you don't have an iPhone, grab your friend's iPhone. Type in Mostly Speaking Sentai in the podcast app. Uh-huh. They probably have it, hopefully, if they don't download it. And do a 5-star review and say, James, you're friggin' trash and I want to use you as a toilet. Not sexually.
Why not?
Because are you writing the review?
No.
Then I don't want them to use me as a toilet.
Getting a lot of mixed messages here. I was under the impression I was here to treat you like a toilet.
Oh, shoot.
Yeah. I kind of told him that. It
mouth,
was okay.
Chest, or lap. Those are your, or
I'm gonna leave you in suspense.
Okay.
I just want you to think about what you've done.
Oh, we don't have a like human swing, so I can't be suspended.
Mm-hmm. Yet.
Oh yeah, okay. I'm gonna close my eyes and all of a sudden I'm gonna be in a swing, guys. Also,
I'm gonna leave.
MLMpod.com/donate. Let us buy a human swing.
God damn.
I'm kidding, we
what
will
other
not.
What kind of swing is there? Human swing?
No, it's like a sex swing.
Okay, but you said human swing.
So not a swing made of humans.
No, not a human
swing. Not a swing made of disloyal Burger King employees.
No. Oh, you want to know what?
That does strike your fancy, though, doesn't it?
If there's a disloyal employee, I'll turn them into a swing. Yeah, swing them out of the friggin' doors and say, get a new job, but you can't because I've flagged you at every place because it's a setup. It's a goddamn conspiracy on our hand. And you know, when we throw around that C word, conspiracy, I'm quoting a sample from a hip hop song that I don't know the original quote. I don't know, guys. Listen to Insane Poetry's The Snuff Reels.
Wow.
Where was I? But Crotch is a lonely boy, destined to live a life of sadness, for gone are the days of unsafe, life-threatening scuba expeditions to the deepest parts of the planet, a.k.a. my grandpa's stomachs, I mean. That's because both my grandpappies is angels in hell, 666 feet deep, bitch.
James.
Bye-bye, grandpappies.
James! That's fucked up.
I didn't know one, so it's okay for me to say things like
not.
That. My dad's not going to hear this.
What about your other grandpappies?
He is.
My grandpappy is going to hear this?
They all are.
Oh, my grandpappy, I can feel him in the corner of the room, and he's going, yeah, James, this is comedy friggin' gold. You know I'm into that, you know, obscure, like, Eric Andre type shit, me a 78-year-old man. I mean, 78-year-old hell angel. Was that the Hell's Angels? Hell's Angels. Guys, my dad was at Woodstock smashing some hippies. Smashing them in the sexual sense.
Or making human swings.
Yes,
out of them.
Human swings, absolutely. You think a hippie would...
What do you think taught him?
My grandmother taught me how to armpit fart, and my grandpappy told me to hit a hippie. But let's focus on...
It's like King of the Hill.
Yeah, guys. But let's focus on angels from above in the form of aliens who descend onto Ursh from heavens above and kick it cool with some local street youths. That's right. Our boy Crotch is hanging out with the coolest kid in town, Pegasus Jr., PJ for short, and 4'9" for even shorter. Too bad for Crotch. The government found out about him hanging with PJ, and the connection is so poor down on Ursh, he can't ring back to home base. Crotch gets sick with an STI like crotches do, spewing the goo, and PJ is crying over his pale white friend in a tube. Can he fly his new alien bud over a hill on his bike? Can he get him to the mothership? Can he overcome a government agency? No, he must suffer from the trauma of seeing his friend from a faraway planet die and bury him in an unmarked grave deep in the woods. But no, a miracle has happened. Thank you, Jesus Christ, the holiest and only man for me. Crotch got hungry and ate some dessert stuff and grew twice as large that day. The Car Rangers show up on the scene ready to take down the newly huge, thick-ass Crotch. He's gigantic. It's, where am I, guys? I lost track because my eyes crossed. Uh-oh.
He's gigantic because he's thick as hell.
Yeah, oh, fuck, that's why my eyes are crossing. A gigantic cross. It's every man's dream to become a big-ass Crotch and every cuck's mission to shoot them down. I say cuck too much in these episode summaries. How about this? The sweaty bourgeoisie cucks on a mission to say, oh, that cat. I love you, Nicole. That's filled a lot of people's mostly speaking Sentai bingo cards because I say those things a lot. Those are my catchphrases.
Are they really?
Yes, they are. Like, I talk about taking down the bourgeoisie a lot and the rise of the proletariat, which is a thing I want. Screw corporations, really. I'm a sleeper cell.
I don't know.
But I love me some Burger King. It's the only corporation that will be standing in post-revolution.
Along with Cutco and Dr. Pepper.
Yes, those three. Because if you're going and getting a fountain drink... You gotta have some cold, crisp Dr. Pepper. And how are you gonna cut that huge-ass Whopper? It's too big for your little mouth. Cutco knife, baby. It can cut leather. It can for sure cut a burger.
I once saw a pack of wolves take over and successfully run a Wendy's.
What is that from?
30 Rock.
All right, guys. You gotta call your jokes.
It's your favorite show.
My favorite show is a goddamn training video for Burger King.
Uh-huh.
But not Car Ranger, the show that you literally do a podcast about.
Yeah. Where am I? Oh, but the Car Ranger.
The gas crotch.
No, the thickest of crotch.
Restart.
Today in a hot, stank summer room, we watched episodes 4 and 5. I'm kidding, guys. But the Car Ranger's weapons aren't strong enough, and Crotch brought a friend along, a hungry little frog inside another hungry frog's mouth. They figure out that it's dessert that made Crotch grow big, and to the listeners, his real name is Grotch, actually. So please, we do not want to be responsible for hundreds of desserts being defaced, disgusted, and deflowered because you thought, well, if eating dessert would give me a bigger crotch, rubbing chocolate pie and mashed cake pops on it will streamline the entire thing. No, no, no. But all seems lost as the Car Rangers see the giant Bozak tear the town apart. So Dapu prays to the pagan forces that be, GM, Chrysler, AMC Gremlin, and the almighty Model T for the power needed to fry this frog in a patch of mama's spicy gumbo, Cajun accent, and save the day. Well, Cajun accent was written down. Through a capitalistic bloodletting to the corporations that be, the automatons gift the Car Ranger with their dream cars in return for their screaming souls. That's not written. The Rangers use the new car magic to rip this frog from mouth of the other frog and smash them to a bloody pulp. In the end, we learn that you are what you eat. So if you're a building-sized Bozak, you're just a sugary sweet boy. And if you're an American, you're a million freaking lies, because that's what the lamestream media has been feeding you since birth. Car Ranger.
Car Ranger?
Car Ranger.
You hear those cicadas?
Yeah, I hope they don't bleed into the mics. So guys, first, Matthew, what'd you think of Car Ranger?
The Car Rangers are all assholes, man.
What?
Yeah, absolutely.
Oh, man.
Yeah, I mean, so literally we have the colostomy potato bag monster who shows up. Groth, or Grotch.
Grotch. We call him Crotch, though.
Okay. So he shows up, and literally he's just hungry. He wants to eat some chicken, so he gains a lot of weight, like 300 tons, as he like increases or whatever, and I get that. And that little kid just makes fun of him. And then the Car Rangers show up, and without any sort of due process, they just start shooting him. They don't read him any rights. They're just like, hey, you're fat. And then they start shooting him.
Later on, later on in the series, a space cop does show up and tells them that they need to be following the law, like they can't be speeding in their go-karts. So someone does call them out on this.
And the chronic alien abuse? Because, you know, the only thing resembling any kind of positive moral came from the other monster, the frog one, M.M. Morg, right?
Yes, Mogul.
So he shows up. He grows to, you know, the heights that his, like, dreams and his, you know, inner strength lets him do. And then he feels really self-conscious about a belly button. And then he can't do anything. He's crippled by the way that he looks. And then our potato bag monster goes and convinces him, hey, don't worry about how you look. Just because you have a weird belly button, you can go out and do anything, including destroy the world. But whatever. And like, so he gets convinced of this, and he finally finds the self-respect to go out and do what he needs to do. And then once again, without due process, he's murdered by the Car Rangers.
Hey guys, you heard it here first. Car Rangers, they're bad. They need to be put behind bars.
They really do. I mean, it's just, yeah.
What if I told you this group of aliens...
But they're trying to blow up the Earth.
Yes, the group of aliens have blown up many planets.
Yeah.
Like they blew up Dapu's planet.
Did they really?
Yeah.
I mean,
yes.
Are we all here to trust the Mogwai dipped in Nair?
They show it.
I'm not really sure.
The first episode.
Yeah.
Well, I didn't see the first episode. So.
And he's a Furby dipped in Nair.
Oh, also, okay. I wanted to show you this.
I mean, Grant, you've recorded this, so now I believe it.
Oh, I just heard Frank.
I'm Dapu.
That is actually just the baby from dinosaurs.
Yeah, I made this for a Car Ranger video of saying that this is Dapu.
I see. But there's literally a scene in here. Hold on. I have a note because I took a lot of notes. So the alien, our potato colostomy bag alien, Grotch, the second time he shows up and talks to the kid just starts beating him with a stick and he runs away and he literally says, "Stop bullying me." I mean, do you think this violence isn't like earned? These people did these to these aliens and then they're just reacting. If all these aliens know is violence, of course they're going to act violently. And what do our heroes do this whole time? They militarize. They're sitting there. They're building a weapon of mass destruction to go and do what? Kill aliens who have been bullied by little boys.
Guys, I'm...
The green ones trying to smash up the town.
Yeah, but again, maybe violence is all he's ever known. Is it really his fault?
Yeah.
I don't know. Yes. Do we get an arc showing his childhood?
No.
We do not.
But we do get them blowing up Dapu's planet and murdering his mother and father.
What really led them to do that? What are the motivations of our villains? I guess I'm just
saying. Does it matter?
I actually do know their motivations. They are trying to get Zonetta naked. They're trying to get her so... She wants all these planets to turn into fireworks to, I guess, get hot and heavy. And Nicole, I'm so glad you don't want me to, like, pretty much commit genocide for you to be like, that gets me going. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
I guess I just feel the show is very shallow in its depiction of the villains. And so, you know, sure, maybe that's the objective, that they're all just a fucking bunch of horn dog aliens and they want the one non-species resembling creature in their ship to get nude for them. But she also has like the mentality of a child, which maybe was the result of brain damage from other Wabu likes. Like maybe those people mentally like disabled her in some fashion. And so they're going along with it, but really they just want revenge because the Nair-ridden Mogwais have gone around and harassed them for thousands of years with their literal car magic, also known as WMDs, that they are slinging around to attack these aliens.
Do you want to know?
Do you secretly work for Creepypasta writing alternate like
no, I've just seen two
shows.
Car Ranger episodes today. So,
do you want to know Zonetta's backstory?
No, I don't know. Where is this coming from? Which news source are you getting this backstory from? Which Car Ranger wiki and or Car Ranger series are we getting this from? Because, you know, there's a lot of versions out there. And like, I don't want to be taken by you know, fake media. Because we know fake media is on a rampage.
Yeah, we do. Mm-hmm. So it's maybe episode... Okay, is episode like 46 fake media?
Maybe. I haven't seen it.
Dapu's an unreliable narrator. That's all we're going to say.
I mean, I don't have any tangible proof that he isn't.
He's Kaiser Sose.
I mean, because the other thing is the show that I watched today, and the audience should know this, it was subtitled.
Yeah.
It was in Japanese. I couldn't understand it. So those subtitles could be very misconstrued.
Oh,
so maybe what should the Car Rangers have done instead of beating them up?
They should have shown up and they should have been like, "Hey, hey, hey, potato bag monster. Hey, hey, Moag, stop. We have weapons. We're not going to engage you. We just want to know what's the deal." They could have de-escalated
the
conflict.
And then they would have said, "We want to blow up the planet."
Maybe.
But the first time, he would have just said, "Hey, I'm trying to blow off some steam. I got yelled at, and I'm trying to eat."
I'm pretty sure he was just like,
James,
I didn't mean, you know, it's like.
Yeah, I flipped, guys.
I'm pretty sure he would have just been like, and this is the potato monster, Grotch. I'm pretty sure he would have just been like, "Hey, I gained a lot of weight because I ate some fried chicken. But man, is this fried chicken dope. Now, for my corporate loyalty, Jewel fried chicken is literally the most amazing fried chicken on the planet. And let's face it, if I had to kill some kids for some Jewel fried chicken, I probably would."
And you wouldn't see yourself as a villain because you're just doing it because you're hungry.
Question. Have you had Jewel fried chicken?
No, I'm a vegetarian.
So I'm just going to say that maybe you don't quite understand what it does. Yeah, I don't know. It makes people do crazy things. Mm-hmm. You know what else makes people do crazy, reckless things? Being a bunch of teenagers pumped up on speed, given cars that are literally WMDs, because then maybe they'll just go power mad and kill monsters that were literally just fucking hungry. I mean, you know, we're always talking about how Wabu lost his plant. Wabu lost his plant.
Dabu.
What about whatever? What about their planet? All they have is like a spaceship that, as far as I can tell, is a single studio apartment in space.
No, they're like at a bar or something.
Yeah. So they have one bar.
Yeah, that's as much bar as you need for
we
a space station.
Maybe they
so
have
why does Wabu and all the other
go.
Hairless Mogwai get a whole planet? Maybe they were just
they actually don't get. Okay, this is sounding very much like pro-Israel, anti-Israel stuff. Like, that's where this is falling under. So, guys,
this coming from the corporate shadow government over here.
Let us know: are you pro-hazard or anti-hazard? Because that's the name of the planet.
Oh, the which
Dabu's planet?
Dabu's planet.
Yes, yeah.
Oh, I'm definitely against hazard.
Uh oh,
definitely. I just didn't, from the two episodes I saw, I did not see why these aliens deserve to get shot at without due process.
They've had, you want to know what? No. If just we are basing it off these two episodes, you are correct, sir. Until the end.
Yes, I am, because it was recorded.
Until the
Car end. Car Rangers are assholes.
They were just in attacking these people, because then they saw, mm-hmm. they put these evil cars on them as well, with the wumpers at wheel.
So they attack them viciously with bumper cars, is what you're saying?
Yeah. Guys, let us know. Are you for the Car Ranger in this episode or against? Hashtag, let's just do pro-hazard. Hashtag, no hazard.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
What else? What other notes do you have? This was a fresh take.
He broke the podcast.
I mean, I think we also
guys,
broke
the
podcast.
Guys, this is the last episode. We're done.
Oh, God.
Let's see here. Well, I guess I'm glad I did that then. If I had the power to do that. I mean,
it's recorded, so it's true.
Let's see. Nope. No due process. No due process.
You had that multiple times.
Yeah.
My first note is I would trip so many kids if I could.
Oh, yeah. And then the Car Rangers. Definitely a bad influence. Again, we're going back to environment or whatever. So the first time the kid is just picking on the potato bag alien. But then later on,
after potato bag alien tripped him with his powers,
pretty sure the kid came at him insulting him right off the bat. He called him fat and stuff. He felt sad. And then the kid just started laughing or whatever.
But the kid, he also does hold the kid hostage for food.
Yeah. He does, but the kid was being a little shit leading up to that, so it's
yeah, but was the mom being a little shit?
No, she was definitely terrified. But then again, I know she fainted later, and that
but
was like...
But the kid helped him, though.
Get the food by being a hostage?
Yeah, he was like, what's all the good food? And the kid was mm-hmm. like, this and this
and then,
this. And
then Crotch put in words into a calculator, so what is a word calculator?
Yeah, so... I guess you're right. Maybe it was just mistranslation.
Yeah.
Maybe Grotch really didn't understand the situation. Maybe it was a very big misunderstanding. But he did not actually physically hurt the kid. In fact, the catalyst was mother fainted, and then Car Rangers were like, all right, time to die, potato bag monster.
After he threatened to hurt the kid.
According to the subtitles that we saw.
Oh, do you want to know what?
God.
I'm going to support your theory even more, because one of my first notes is... This kid's a Trumpster making fun of aliens.
Yeah, exactly. And going back to the Car Rangers being a bad influence, after the kid sees the Car Rangers show up, shoot the alien, all that, the next scene with the kid, he starts attacking the monster with a stick. So this kid has been indoctrinated towards violence.
Yeah.
After he was held hostage twice.
Mm.
That kid
what
was.
What do you mean, maybe? Yes,
they might have just been hugging. And being like,
no.
I would like some fried chicken.
He said, get me some food or I'll hurt this child.
I mean, I'm just saying, who are you going to believe, you know? The subtitles by the, who?
By a bunch of fan subbers?
I'm
or?
Just saying, you should be questioning the media that you ingest.
Yeah,
including
Nicole.
These shows, because You know what? I lived most of my life believing Power Rangers was an American show. And then I found out, I was like, oh my goodness, it was made in Japan. They put in new actors. They changed everything. So I don't know what to believe anymore, people.
Believe your gut. And that's what you're doing.
Right. And the Power Rangers are assholes. So I have not changed my position on this.
Oh man, Frank, you yawning. Frank was looking tentatively at Matthew preach, guys.
Yeah.
Frank believes you as well.
Yeah.
Let me get some of my starred notes. Man, they were supposed to, in order to get their huge mechas and their dream cars, they had to dream with a pure mind. I dream with a filthy mind.
Yeah, I, for some reason, thought, because I've seen this episode before, I thought they made a joke like that, but they didn't.
Frank, quit meowing at me. But, Nicole, what do you feel about Car Ranger now?
I don't fucking know, man.
It seemed like you were loving these episodes. Like when the guy was, they were singing along in the car.
Okay, because the one was really tiny and I thought it was cute. And then he like set him on his shoulder and they were like singing along and it was cute. And then he got, the tiny one got big and then he was self-conscious. And then Crotch was like, it's okay, I'm grosser. And then he was like, oh, okay.
Smell my dirty button.
And then I forgot what happened, but then Crotch like fell over because he was like, whoa.
Everything you loved about this episode was the Bozak. Nicole's on board with us too, guys.
No, I never said they were good.
Cute equals good.
No.
I'm not here to take a moralistic stand to say that they're totally benevolent. I'm just saying that maybe they were harassed. Okay. They're misunderstood. I think it's a gray area.
So you're saying that like someone, if they have a shitty past, they can just do whatever the fuck they want?
No.
Oh, you're putting word in his mouth.
You are. I think there's a reasonable reaction that the Car Rangers could have taken.
It's okay that Trump is the way he is because he had a bad childhood.
That dude had a fantastic childhood. His dad was rich. He was a millionaire.
You don't know.
That's what Trump has told me, and I believe him because it's not coming from CNN or goddamn Washington Post or maybe the New York Times.
Came straight from the donkey's ass.
Yeah. Oh, whoa.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Are they elephants? Who's the elephant and who's the donkey?
Democrats are donkey and Republicans are elephants.
Yeah, straight from the elephant's ass. I mean, mouth. Oh, elephants go ass to mouth.
Elephant's dick. My bad.
Can an elephant's trunk touch their butt?
I don't know.
Okay, guys, let us know. If you're a biologist? Yeah, a zoologist. Let us know. Hashtag...
Don't.
Ella butt.
Hashtag don't.
Out of all the hashtags we do, like one person does it, and it's usually Steve F or It Takes Two to Toku, and we thank you. Also, people did the hashtag Nicole is beautiful. Multiple people did. You're beautiful. You're money, baby.
Zanette jump roping.
Okay, yes. Let's get into that.
That was funny too.
I said, why seek world domination when you can watch Zonetta just jump rope all day?
That's the thing, is she wants the earth to explode. So they do what she says so that they can be around her.
Yeah.
That's why.
Her backstory just hits home so hard. We'll find out more later.
It did remind me of like a debaucherous Buffalo Wild Wings. They're like little watching her just do her jump rope.
On a pedestal.
Yeah. It was very strange. And I was like, oh, okay. So this is a good 90-second segment that we have for this.
Coyote Ugly meets B-dubs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You got to go to B-dubs, guys. You ever been to B-dubs?
You know, you've pushed so much corporate sponsorship on me in one podcast. I can only give you two. You can two of your corporate sponsors. You can push on me.
Okay, let's think. NRA's got to be incorporated. So NRA and...
I take it back. I take it back immediately.
Oh, yikes.
And Volkswagen in like 1943.
Why?
That sounds problematic.
because it is. Yeah. They were making vehicles for the regime.
Cool.
Guys, the only roaches I kiss are goddamn small joints. Hashtag roach clip if you know that struggle. or scraping resin out of bowls just to get a little high because your town is dry. Oh, that's my childhood. Legalizing marijuana is ruining my childhood. These kids just can go buy weed. I had to wait around stems and seeds. Back in my day, a nickel bag cost like $15.
Back in my day, I had to work at Burger King for 6 years to get a single joint.
Guys, Burger King did suck, and I was so amped, I left that and just blared No Bunny or Hunks and His Punks. Yeah, it was Hunks and His Punks, sure. Street Punks, that album, the entire way home to the shitty trailer we lived in.
Yeah, good times.
Grand old times.
And you know, you wonder why we left.
No, I don't wonder why we left Muskegon.
I'm just saying, like, in general.
Oh, but it's on.
Like,
it's,
no wonder why
guys,
we left.
You have to watch Muskegon Go. They're on the up and up.
What is Muskegon Go?
I mean, yeah, if you're a white person.
Yes, absolutely. So it says, like, watch Muskegon, but it's stylized. So, like, M-U.
The G-O is, like, highlighted or
yeah,
whatever.
So, like, it's M-U-S-K, then G-O-N. Mm-hmm. So it's, like, watch Muskegon, but then they highlight the U.S. and the G-O-P, and then that says watch us go.
And G-O-P?
Yeah, guys. You down with G-O-P? Yeah, you know me. Oh, God. Paul Ryan, if you're running again, I have a fucking catchy-ass theme for you. Paul Ryan was on a couple episodes ago.
Oh, yeah. Not the actual congressman, Paul Ryan. No,
yes, Paul Ryan showed up because we said his name three times.
And naturally showed up. And because it was recorded, it was true. Okay.
Yes.
Okay, I see.
Yeah.
So what's the catchy phrase?
Oh, you down with G-O-P? Yeah, you know me.
Oh, that was it.
Yeah, that. Appropriating culture to, you know.
I forgot why we went this far.
I don't know.
Have you ever wondered if you've gone too far?
Always. Anytime I say anything, I just pick it apart in my head until I hate myself.
Why? I love everything. You burp into a mic and I'm fascinated.
It's true. It did elevate this podcast, I will say.
Guys, we got to fill her up with Dr. Pepper so she's burping all the time. Use promo code Nikki Jake Burpy Burp.
Nickel Bricks.
Ooh, the hashtag Nickel Bricks. Let us know if you love Dr. Pepper. Oh, also, I wanted to say that although I enjoy Dr. Pepper, I am a Faygo loyalist because I was a Juggalo and, you know.
I mean, if it's got a logo, you're for it, right?
Yeah.
That's kind of my takeaway from tonight's episode.
I wear the Mostly Speaking Sentai logo on my back.
That makes sense. You're promoting your own brand.
Yeah.
But it's this other loyalty that I see from you.
See, I don't really like vibe with CM Punk, except I really like his like arm tattoo of the Pepsi logo.
Did they pay him to do that?
No, because he's straight edge. So he's like, I'll drink soda, not.
So they still could have paid him.
Yeah.
I think he
could have gotten it after the fact if he blew up and then like made an effort to really like show off the tattoo.
Oh, he shows it off at, like whenever he puts someone in a headlock. You better believe they're zoomed up on that. Wonder if they would have to blur it out if Coca-Cola was a sponsor for WWE.
They could rotoscope it and then put, you know, a different logo in the spot of it, you know.
Pay him
depending on the budget
it.
But like Coca-Cola's got that money. I mean,
do like a henna tattoo to make it like a smiley face or the Coca-Cola bear.
Oh, the polar bear.
Yeah. Nicole, you like polar bears? You know they have translucent hair.
This is a trap.
They have translucent hair.
Okay.
Why is this a trap?
I don't know. I'm about to find out.
No, it's not.
You're just gonna walk into it.
Okay.
They're A-okay.
Okay.
They're dying though. World's heating up. Just like me on a goddamn rap song. Ooh, baby.
I just really want to pet Frank.
Yeah, well,
he's
can.
He's so cute and handsome.
Do you have any more notes?
No, I really just had that big one and I, you know, my rant really covered most of them.
Destroying our livelihood.
You mean opening your eyes to the real truth? Yes. I think I have said my bit.
Oh, also, I meant to say last time, you know, I want to learn that, like, Gekiso Sentai Car Ranger, and they do the thumbs up. I know it's super easy, but, like, I can't get the Crunchwrap Supreme. This is the Crunchwrap Supreme. It's good to go. So I have it down.
Oh, my God. If you do that one more fucking time.
Oh, I just did it. Oh, I just double Crunchwrap.
He does it, like, 30 yes. times a
Listeners,
day.
Listeners, he's really bad at it.
Oh, Frank agreed with you. Or maybe he's agreeing with me.
I don't know. Frank sounds really upset.
It. Oh, no. Yeah. Frank. Yeah.
Man,
do they offer classes?
For Crunchwraps?
Because maybe.
You got to get a job at Taco Bell.
Oh, that's true. You could put in 6 years at a Taco Bell and then really get it down, right?
Yeah. I'm glad I only did 1 year at Dr. Pepper because that place was terrible.
You actually worked at a Dr. Pepper? Yeah. I'm actually legitimately interested in this. I'm sorry, everybody.
I stocked shelves. I was a merchandiser so I just like go to all these stores in the area, go to the back room and put the stock up.
Interesting.
Yeah. It was a terrible job.
Hmm.
Also because I didn't have soles on my shoe. So trying to move. So like there was one time in a Walmart that I had a hand jack, a hand lift, you know, whatever you call them.
Yeah.
And I was just, it was way too heavy to be even moving, but I wanted to get things moving quickly. True. And I was just like moving as if I was in a cartoon, just like running full speed, but standing in the same spot, just like, ugh, because I didn't have any soles on my shoe.
Like really high piano keys.
Yeah. So an assistant manager at Walmart saw me and said, hey, do you need help? Because I'm pretty sure you do. And then they said, you know, we have a sale on shoes. And guess what? I went and bought some shoes.
Wow.
Yeah.
So he got you to show up, deliver product, and buy something from the store?
Yes, they did.
Wow.
Yeah. They were cool. I liked that assistant manager.
Yeah.
And the person who worked the back room, she was salty. She hated people, and it was cool. Mm. Yeah, guys.
Grumpy people are my favorite.
But why are you with me? What if I started being
grumpy?
I don't
know. It doesn't make any fucking sense, man.
What if I started being grumpy? Would you still like me?
Yeah.
No, you wouldn't, because I get, like, somewhat angry, and you're like, why
Not
are
when
you so
you're mad.
Angry?
No, because you're... No, okay, you have you have two modes. It's either this... okay. Or you're like, God fucking damn it, Jesus Christ.
I learned it from my dad.
I think there's something to be said between, there's a difference between angry and grumpy. Grumpy's kind of like a state of being.
Yeah.
You know? And then anger is like violent outbursts.
Exactly.
My favorite dwarf from Snow White was Manic. He just goes around and he's like,
huh.
Yeah. I mean, I just am dopey by default.
Yeah, girl, you dope as hell. All right. Do you have any more notes, Nicole? Nikki Jakester?
I do have one. Okay. So, like, I know I've seen these episodes as we watch them. I'm like, oh, I've seen James watching this before, like, earlier in the year. So far, whenever there's a kid, it's always the president's son.
Yes.
And I really like that it's just, like, that he's a recurring character and that it's not just like some random child every time.
Oh God, it would be so terrible.
The child is the son of the president?
That's what they call him.
The guy who runs the company, the president of the car company.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
The mechanic shop, the guy with the mustache.
Right.
They call him the president.
Huh. I guess that explains the kid's violent tendencies because he's an entitled rich kid like Trump was.
Wow.
Right?
Oh, he and Anya Nicole. He's taking your thoughts and friggin' bending them. He's a thought
No,
bender.
Actually, the reason why he had violent tendencies is because he was held fucking hostage.
Or hugged. It's up for debate.
Yeah, guys.
No, it's not.
Guys, if you are kidnapping someone, just say you are hugging them real tight. And guess what?
I don't think you should give advice like that up.
That's a solid case in the courts.
Huh.
Hey guys, the thoughts and opinions of James are not that of a trained lawyer.
Even though they're recorded.
Which does mean they're true.
Oh, fuck, guys. You have to listen to me, whatever I say. Which, guys, Mrs. Pegasus, you know, the kid's mom and whatnot, I think she's elevated to above Rain and above Zonetta. That's who Nicole wishes.
The president's wife?
Yeah.
is named Mrs. Pegasus.
I mean, that's
why
are
you calling her that?
Because that's the guy's, his name is
President Pegasus.
Like, that's his last name.
Child Pegasus.
Since yeah. When?
Billy Pegasus.
Yeah.
President Pegasus.
Yeah.
And First PJ. Lady Pegasus.
Pegasus Jr. PJ, baby.
No.
I'm pretty sure that's what I'm just calling him. But who Nicole wants to friggin' kiss her if I were in her body? That's a recurring thing. Is
you in, body snatching, Nicole?
If I were born in... No. If
no,
I were
him
born,
body snatching characters from Sentai.
Yeah, oh, I see.
Nicole would prefer me in a lady's body.
It happens.
Because then I'd be fucking sexy as hell. Right now I'm just like, I'm sexy as heaven. But she wants it as hell. All right, guys. I don't think we don't have any more notes. Any last words? Also, yes? I don't know.
What?
I'm bad at English.
Corporate sponsorship. It really, it can really mess with you, man.
Yeah, guys. Please, for the love of God, give your money to things such as Walmart. Don't go to your local comic shop.
James, literally cut you.
Buy your comics on Amazon or Barnes and Noble
so
online.
This is actually the line. This is the actual line. Okay.
Don't fucking go into your goddamn store and be like, two employees that work there that
depend on this income,
love this shop.
Preach.
And say, oh, I'm just gonna buy this on Amazon because fuck you.
Wow.
All right, so on that, would you continue watching Sentai?
I don't know, probably not.
Okay.
Maybe.
This is
Matthew's like, oh shit, I've done that.
So we absolutely need to have you back. We would love to get you with Melzer on a Mostly Love and Lucha.
That'd be amazing.
Sure. Yeah.
Are you aware of the show Los Luchadores?
No.
It was a Fox Kids show, also done by Saban.
Okay.
About a group of luchador wrestlers who fight crime.
So I can already say that the tangent of the conversation diving into mound goats and all of the luchador things that Melzer and I are very pro is probably, well, maybe it's exactly what you're looking for.
Yeah, it is.
But it'll be a huge tangent off
good.
From that. Yeah.
We
I'm really at
that.
My peak when I'm being cynical and a jackass in general. So like, it's something that we can really quip on because we'll probably fall in love with it.
Oh, he's been on for two of those episodes. Melzer's been on more episodes than anyone, I think. He's at like four or five.
Yeah. All right.
He's
a
good boy.
I'll come back with him.
Yes.
That sounds fun.
Yes.
Who?
I have a question.
Yeah, what's up?
Did you go to G-Fest this year?
I did not.
Dang.
Yeah.
Yeah, because that's how we originally met. We met at Melzer's birthday party. And we started talking Godzilla.
Yep.
What's your favorite Godzilla movie?
Ooh, rough question. Heavy question. So there's a couple. It depends. It depends on the mood that I'm like looking for.
Yeah.
Right? I would say as a child, like sentimental reasons, it's Godzilla versus Gigan.
Nice.
Which like 90% of that movie is recycled footage from Ghidorah, the three-headed monster. they just threw in a couple shots of a new Godzilla costume and what's his face and Gigan, and that's basically it. But otherwise, it's just Ghidorah, the three-headed monster, redone, redubbed, and it's hilarious.
It.
Yeah, I love it. It was the only one that we owned growing up,
yeah.
And then I had a friend who he and his brother had like the entire Godzilla collection.
Same.
Yeah, so it was very. Learned envy at a young age, you know. but outside of that, I would say I was objectively surprised by how good, you know, like in an anime sense, because it felt like a proper anime, was, what do they call it? I think the English translation is just Godzilla versus Mechagodzilla, or maybe it's Godzilla against Mechagodzilla. And it's from the second wave of films, like in the 90s. Where each episode was like a standalone, like a new canon, basically.
Wait, so...
So what was that? The Heisei period?
The Heisei?
Yeah.
So it would be Godzilla versus Mechagodzilla 2?
No, not that one, because that one specifically has Rodan, right?
Yes.
Okay, so the one I'm talking about is the one where Mechagodzilla is actually like a mech suit, more or less.
Okay, yeah, so that's against Mechagodzilla.
It is against, yes. Yeah, I knew it was something kind of quirky like that. Yeah, so I think that one, I was blown away. I actually thought one that was really kind of good. It
is
was
that
like,
the one with the girl who has a flower?
Yes.
Yes, that's one of Nicole's favorites,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's the, yeah, so the main character is that pilot, and she loses some friends to Godzilla, and then she's like, she has to work her way back up to the respect of her peers to operate the Mechagodzilla suit, which is made off of the carcass of the original Godzilla. Come on, it's great. And the fights are fun, and like the characters through arc actually makes sense. Now, the third favorite Godzilla film, for the exact opposite reason, for a film that makes no sense, Godzilla vs. Space Godzilla.
Oh, yeah. Oh, did you see our poster?
I did not see your poster.
Oh, we have the movie poster hanging on the wall just on, in that room.
I just, the last time I watched that, the first 40 minutes is just the Japanese mob. They want to kidnap a telepath. They want to cut out her brain and put somebody else in her body. But doesn't that like defeat the purpose of having a telepathic person, is their mind? And I just, that's within the first 40 minutes. And then, by the way, there's a giant space monster attacking the planet.
Yeah.
And like, I don't think the arc with the Yakuza and the telepath and the G unit on the motorcycles and stuff, like, I don't think any of that has anything to do with the monsters threatening the world. And of the of all the monsters, because all monsters are just like animals, minus Space Godzilla, because he's like a ridiculous Vegeta showing up just to like mock his enemies and make it rain crystals from the sky, which, don't ask me how he does that.
Oh, well,
or
no,
any of his powers.
This is how he does it. Remember,
Godzilla's cell went through a black hole and came out a
after
white
after the fight
hole.
With Biollante, right?
No,
wasn't
after
their
the
little
fight,
that's how he got the mandibles, is from Biollante, I thought.
From Batra or Mothra. What, I think Mothra took Batra into space and they blew up in the sun, maybe,
is
something
that
like
what
that.
What they did?
Yeah.
I thought they made a big deal because Biollante, when he died, did that weird like golden sparkle thing where he flew up into the sky.
Oh, all of them do that golden sparkle thing,
yeah.
So it's hard to gauge it.
Well, we would need another conversation.
Yeah.
We're really gonna get into Godzilla because that's the whole
All right. Should we improv, or are we? We do this thing where we do an improv, but every improv always segues into us telling people to donate to getting us something to make the studio better.
I would love to hear you all beg for money.
Do you do improv?
No.
Okay. You're a man of the written word.
Well, I am a knight.
Yes, of the. I don't know where I was going with that. That's our improv style. Would you like to improv?
No, but I will gladly watch you all improv.
Okay, Nicole.
Oh, God.
You started out, baby. Let's go.
Why do I always have to start?
You want to know what? This is great. Give us a word.
Can it be a phrase?
Yeah.
Abuse of power and silence.
Okay. You're doing that totally wrong. You need to be scrubbing the vomit
God
back and forth.
Damn it.
Hey.
I'm doing it right.
Okay. One, I am your superior. Don't fucking swear at me.
Oh, my God.
Okay? And remember, I'm a new guy. I'm trying to shake things up a little bit. Front to back with the puke, stomach acid.
Okay.
It's going to be crystal clear.
Okay.
Okay? Jinx. Sure. Please stop talking. I jinxed you, and
or
also
what, you'll hit me.
No,
you'll hit me.
You want to know what?
Because that's how that works.
I'll make you scrub the goddamn drive-through. That's what I'll make you do, and it's goddamn 100 degrees out there. Okay. Oh, you have nothing
Fine.
To say. All right. So I'm going to go to the office.
Yeah.
And act like I'm punching in numbers, but really I'm just sitting there doing absolutely
okay,
nothing.
Yeah. On your little handheld bullshit.
Yeah. All right. So I'm going to leave, okay?
Uh-huh.
And my name's been Caleb. So if someone else with my voice comes in this room, it's probably going to be someone else.
It's not Mike.
Hey, what's up? It's me, Mike.
No, I'm saying the other person is... Never mind.
No, that's Caleb. This is Mike.
Okay,
I got
sure.
a mustache. I just want you, what do you think about Caleb over there?
That was the name of the regional manager in real life.
Who?
Nothing, never mind. I'm just mumbling to myself.
So, what you doing right there? What do you think of Caleb?
I'm fucking scrubbing this puke.
Yeah, he's a smart guy.
Are you gonna help?
Hey, I'm gonna have to go punch numbers if you want me to help.
Okay. Uh-huh.
You know?
What?
To be honest, I think we could just subvert this entire process right here.
Subvert it?
Yeah, subverse it. Instead of submerge it in this water. Instead of tile floors, we could get something that doesn't need to be mopped.
Then how would you get the puke out?
Oh, well, no, we don't even put the puke there at all. Why is there a cat here?
Okay. He just got in.
Oh, man. Yeah.
We just let him run around.
Sometimes squirrels will get in here. Sometimes rats and mice will get in here.
You know, like we should do something about it, but who cares?
Yeah, you know, hey, if we spend another dollar towards exterminating things, well, then the managers will have to work 6 days a week. And that's why, you know, sometimes we don't have hand soap. Sometimes we don't have,
dish soap.
Sometimes we don't have sanitizer, things that, you know, the health department, if they came, we would get written up for that. And guess what? A lot of our assistant managers need ServSafe, but we don't want to pay them that extra quarter for having ServSafe.
And, you know, the like squirrels and stuff.
Absolutely. They'll work their way out eventually. And if a customer sees it, we'll just call them crazy. Things that have happened.
That has happened?
Yeah, like they're like, no, we don't know anything about that.
Oh my God.
So how are we, what do you think we could do to just subvert tile floor whatsoever?
I mean, besides just burning this place to the ground?
Now, that is an excellent idea because we do have insurance. However, how are we going to make it look like an accident?
We can make it more flammable.
You want to know what? We can do this by not paying people to clean the grease traps up above, and then that will eventually bring a fire, and then we're saving money.
And if there
money.
Was, like, something to absorb it on the ground.
Ooh, it's like something flammable on the ground, too.
Yeah, to just really soak up the grease.
What could we use? Like one of those slip mats?
I'm just fucking mopping this vomit, man. You tell me.
Oh, man, we could use an area rug, but we don't have enough money to do that. That's right, guys. Go to mlmpod.com/donate. We got to get an area rug to dampen some of this echo in the room. And so when Frank pukes, we don't have to clean it up. It just gets soaked up by the rug.
Ew.
Ooh, and then you're smelling it and you're like, wow, that smells like something
that
would
fucking
destroy
disgusting.
Grease. Holy crap, Frank, he wasn't sick. He was just telling us, hey, there's some grease on the ground.
Yeah.
Usually our improvs aren't that angry.
Nope. I appreciated this one.
I feel like it's very, with the episode.
It definitely brings it full circle.
Tied it back in.
To, I mean, we heard a lot of like reminiscing about the experiences, but now I feel like I lived through it.
Yeah.
Yep.
Jinx.
It's great.
So, Matthew, what do you have to plug?
Oh, yeah, I guess that's a good question, huh? We have a web series. Again, our name is Muscular Clown is the name of our group, and we have a web series called Todd Grobin's Going Away Party. It's a production where we partnered with Channel Flux, and we hope to have it out in the fall sometime of 2019.
Fingers crossed, guys. Yep. It's super good. You can, I think, I will link it, because I think if you look for it on YouTube, they don't have it listed on Channel Flux, the first episode, possibly. Mm-hmm. So you have
actually, we may
to...
have taken it down because of our imminent release time coming.
Okay.
Like we're redeploying the pilot. So
all right.
There actually might not be anything to link to. Yes.
But maybe if someone's looking on Amazon Prime, what could they find from a Muscular Clown?
They could definitely find our award-winning web series,
yes,
The Street Wizard's Apprentice, which
it's
is
so
on
good.
Amazon Prime, and it is free if you are a slave to Prime like I am.
Yeah. Oh, speaking of corporate sponsors. Amazon, Audible, IMDb, the book, audiobook place that
Audible?
Is in my, no, it's in Muskegon that I tried getting a job in the warehouse and they said, no.
Right.
But guys, please check out Muscular Clown. It's super great. And on one of those Todd Grobin episodes, I have two rap songs on it now. Nicole, what you got to plug?
Oh, God. Go to darlinghomebody.com to find cool shit that I made, Crumbums, the webcomic, and mostly Sketch and Sentai, where I draw monsters.
Yeah, and we just put out a new one called The Fuck Trumpet. And it's
created
just
created by Courtney.
Yeah, and it's a quick one, time lapse. I put a funky ass sexy beat underneath.
I believe it's episode 7.
Yes, of Mostly Speaking Sentai, yeah. Where it was created. Or 8? No, 8 is with Melzer and Renee and Peter Daddy.
Find me at Darling Homebody on Instagram, Tumblr, and Facebook.
Yeah. Hey, guys, if you want to listen to me 3 other times during the week, check out my other podcasts, Hit It and Crit It, What the Hell Mouth, and This Movie's Gay. You can find information about all those by searching the titles wherever you're listening to this or by going to mlmpod.com. Also, do you want to listen to me make rap music and be really good at it, but for some reason don't have a fan base? Go to mlmpod.com/Marshland Monster to download all of my CDs for free. That's no De Niro. Or go to SoundCloud, YouTube, Facebook. Yeah, babies. I think that's all. Oh, we're hawking CBD oil. There's a link in the description. We get commission if you buy stuff using that link. Please. Also, our Redbubble account.
Yeah, daddies.
Yeah. Also, give us a 5-star review. Tell a fucking friend about the goddamn podcast. I'm very angry right now. I'm so angry. But
no, you're not, because you're not as swearing
opposed to grumpy.
Ooh, I'm never grumpy. I'm just happy to be around.
You are grumpy, like, but very rarely.
Yeah. Hey. God, I'm a little grump guy. Okay. I've been James.
I'm Nicole.
And I'm Matthew.
And we've been, and then we say Mostly Speaking Sentai together, and we've been
Mostly Speaking Sentai.
Bye-bye.
Car Ranger. Hi.
Hello.
Nice. We're looking good, daddies.
Hi.
So we just keep saying hi, right?
Oh, no, no. No.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello. Bonjour.
Hello.
Hi.
Okay. Hello. I'm kidding. All right. This has been a Marshland Media production, produced by James McCullum. For more content, please visit mlmpod.com. To support our network and have access to exclusive podcasts, head over to patreon.com/mlmpod and sign up today.